Ladies and gentlemen, the man who came in so masterfully behind me after the opening strains of that song is the great jazz bassist, songwriter, and accompanist to the stars, and our special guest today, Mr. Jay Leonhart. Jay is a wonderful songwriter in his own right, but Jay, very candidly, have you ever gotten your inspiration from... you don't have to divulge all your secrets, but that's absolutely extraordinary, you know. I mean, and it shows, among other things, the connection between composing and improvising, because obviously Arlen was a wonderful improviser. He was a jazz pianist. And but as we do, or sort of moderately proficient improvisers like myself, little melodic phrases will suggest other melodic phrases. It's just like when you're giving a sales talk, I presume, because I've never given one. But you find yourself covering certain points, and then in the middle, something will occur to you that's inspired. But I mean, I have to confess that I have sat at the piano on many occasions, and it just doesn't go anywhere. But, yeah. That song, of course, the name of it is Get Happy, and Ted Kohler, the lyricist with whom Arlen was to collaborate a lot during the early 30s, did the lyric, and it really put Arlen on the map in terms of being a really major songwriter. You know, how would you characterize, Jay, how would you characterize that song, say, compared with the songs of George Gershwin, who was one of Arlen's major inspirations? I mean, Gershwin was his hero, there's no question about it. But there's something very different about this, the whole feeling of it, and say Gershwin's first hit song, you know, Swanee.
Well, you know, I got to tell you, to me, Howard Arlen has always been sort of like Duke Ellington in that his melodies by themselves are jazz. And you don't really have to play them any much differently than the way he wrote them for them to be jazz.
Yeah, they swing.
Yeah, and and that his influence is completely there. Well, obviously Gershwin's, he was not coming at this from the standpoint of a jazz musician. He was his own individualistic kind of composer, very classically oriented, obviously, from the things he wrote.
And I think also that there was a decade between the time that Gershwin came along. You consider that Swanee was written or published in 1919. And it was, in its way, totally revolutionary. I mean, Gershwin turned music on its head. And he was considered, in his time, as a jazz composer. They didn't know what else to call it. But in the interval of 10 years, you have Arlen coming along and writing something that really swings, which means that music in the meantime had evolved during the 1920s in a very extraordinary way. And Arlen fell under the sway.
Well, and as you pointed out to me, Harold Arlen also had the benefit of hearing people like Louis Armstrong.
Right, who was one of his heroes.
Who Gershwin probably did not hear before he started to write.
Yeah, he listened, I know Gershwin listened to a lot of piano players. Well, nothing wrong with that. I mean, where would I be?
But Louis did change music. Yeah. Louis did change music.
Well, I thought what we could do is Get Happy is very typical of the early songs of Harold Arlen. A lot of his early hit songs were written for Cotton Club revues or their equivalent, and they were introduced by black performers. So I thought perhaps we could do a medley of his hits, three or four of his hits of that early 30s, mid-30s period. And it's important in listening to these to compare them, as we're going to do a little later, with what we call Arlen's mature style, which we're going to get into. He changed in the course of a few years. But anyway, here are some of his famous sort of Cotton Club period songs.